Hi students, good morning to all of you. So today we will discuss about modulus inequalities. Right, in last two videos we discussed about modulus function and when two mods are given then how to solve that problem, that also we discussed. Now we discuss some modulus inequalities. Right, first one, mod x equal to 1. What will happen when mod x equal to 1? What are the values satisfying this one? Mod of 1 is also 1. Mod of minus 1 is also 1. So the numbers, the real values satisfying this equation is x equal to plus or minus. Right. Now mod x less than 1. Mod x less than 1. I want all the numbers on the real line such that mod x less than 1. How you do this one? First, before doing this one, when mod x equal to 1, when x equal to plus or minus 1. So this is the minus 1, this is the 1. Can you tell me what are the numbers satisfying this one? Mod x less than 1, 0, 0.1, 0.5, 0.2, 0.9, minus 0.1. So 0 is there, minus 0.5. What is the mod of minus 0.5? 0.5. Less than 1. So what are the numbers satisfying this? These are all the numbers. That means in between minus 1 and 1. All these numbers are satisfying this inequality. So whenever mod x less than 1, that implies minus 1 less than x less than 1. So x is the number lie between minus 1 and 1. What is this meaning? X belongs to open interval minus 1 comma 1. Next, go through this. Mod x less than or equal to 1. What are the numbers satisfying this inequality? Mod x less than or equal to 1. When mod x equal to 1, when x equal to plus or minus 1. Right. Now, which value is satisfying this? All the numbers in between minus 1 and 1. And also end points minus 1 and 1. So, what is this meaning? Minus 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1. What it means? X belongs to closed interval minus 1 comma 1. Right. Next, this one. Now, what about mod x greater than 1? What are the numbers satisfying this? Mod x greater than 1. What it means? When mod x equal to 1, minus 1 and 1. Which numbers are satisfying? Take 0, mod 0, 0 greater than 1, not possible. Take 2, mod 2, 2, 2 greater than 1, possible. 1.5, mod of 1.5, 1.5 greater than 1, possible. These all numbers are possible. Is these only possible? Are there any other? See, what is mod of minus 2? Mod of minus 3 is 2, 2 greater than 1, that is also possible. So these are all numbers also possible. What is this meaning? That implies x less than minus 1, x less than minus 1 or x greater than 1. That implies x belongs to minus infinity to minus 1. Open union, open 1 to infinity. Correct? Now the last one, mod x greater than or equal to 1. How you do this one? Mod x greater than or equal to 1. This is the real minus 1 and 1. All the numbers before minus 1, all the numbers after minus 1, and also minus 1 1. Like this. And also minus 1 and 1. Right. So what is the question? X less than or equal to minus 1 or x greater than or equal to 1. X less than or equal to minus 1 or x greater than or equal to 1. That implies x belongs to minus infinity to minus 1 closed union closed 1 to infinity. So these are the modulus inequalities. Right. Based on this, I will give another modulus. Right, now see this. mod x equal to u. What is this implies? X equal to plus or minus a. Mod x equal to a, then x equal to plus or minus a. A is a positive number. If a is negative, not possible. Mod x equal to a. Here a is always positive. Next, mod x less than a. Mod x less than a. How you write this one? Minus a less than x less than a. Minus a less than x less than a. That implies x belongs to minus a to a. Next one. Mod x less than or equal to a. That implies minus a less than or equal to x less than or equal to a. That implies x belongs to closed minus a to a. Next one. Mod x greater than a. What it implies? X less than minus a or x greater than a. What is this implies? X belongs to minus infinity to minus a. Union a to infinity. Mod x greater than or equal to that implies x less than or equal to minus a or x greater than or equal to a. What is this implies? X belongs to minus infinity to minus a. Closed union closed a to infinity. Right, friends? So these are the inequalities. There we have written just one f at any number. Now suppose the problem is like this. Suppose the problem is like this. Mod of x minus 3 less than 2. Forget about x minus 3. Take it as mod x only. Mod x less than a. What it means? Minus 2 less than x less than 2. See this? Mod x less than a. What it means? Minus a less than x less than a. That means numbers between minus a to a. Minus 2 to 2. Now we have 3. 3 minus 2 less than x minus 3 plus 3 less than 2 plus 3. So 1 less than x less than, right? This is the interval. But anyways, x belongs to 1 to 5. Suppose the problem is like this. Mod of x minus 3 greater than 2. Mod x greater than a. That means before minus a, after a. That means x minus 3 less than minus 2 or x minus 3 greater than 2. Take 3 this way. X less than 3 minus 2 1 or x greater than 3 plus 2 5. X belongs to minus infinity to 1 union 5 to infinity. Right? So these are the basic type of problems based on mod inequalities. So whenever mod x less than a, x lies between minus a to a. Whenever mod x greater than a, x lies outside minus a and outside a. That means before minus a, after a. Minus infinity to minus a, union a to infinity. And based on these problems only, we are doing. Based on these properties only, we are doing these problems. Right, friends? Try to understand the concept and go through this type of problems one by one. So after that, you will be thorough with this type of problems. Right? Thank you very much.